there's never been more BTS recorded in this house. This is the most insider look that you'll get into the Yes House and into the dynamics of how we run things here, how we create a project, how we edit a project. So stay tuned for the next few minutes and you'll get to see where all the magic happens.
And all the secrets.
Enjoy.
This video documents a week I spent at Yes Theory's headquarters, aka the Yes House. I was there to capture the post-production process for their new documentary called Beyond the Berkshires.
And over there, that's where it came from.
It's about a mass UFO sighting that happened in Berkshire County, Massachusetts back in 1969, with more than 250 witnesses from various towns in the area. Most of these people did not know each other, and some even had eerie encounters that extended far beyond just seeing a UFO.
And I'm like struggling with that my whole life because all I know is that it fucking happened.
Back in October, I joined the Yes Theory team in my home state for a mission to seek the truth about what really happened that night 51 years ago.
That is the eeriest thing I've ever heard.
It's important for me to state how meaningful the creation of this documentary was to everyone involved. The stories we heard and the people we met changed the way we think about our existence in this universe.
My reality was fucking completely violated.
The shenanigans throughout this process kept things fun and provided some comic relief while tackling such an intense project. And if you've ever wondered what really happens at the Yes House, here's the truth.
I was just filming an entrance.
Hi.
How are you doing?
I'm good. Lots of reflections this morning. Wanting to make sure that the story comes out in the best way and for it not to like freak people out. What a crazy story to end 2020 with. Let's go. Let's go.
Welcome to the Yes House. You enter into space.
How appropriate for what we're doing.
Exactly. There's this strange foreshadowing here. Space and the cosmos have been an element of in design and like the different spaces that we had.
This is my favorite. Every time I enter, this really sets a tone.
And I wanted to create like a ritual of every time you come in, hopefully you take a, you pause for a second and then you go up. Let's go.
Let's go.
Truth tellers, baby. But I discovered Yes Theory after the Wim Hof documentary, and then this guy takes me under his wing, and now I'm here, and it's a fucking shit show.
Well, guess
this
what?
Shit is like crazy, the, man.
Hello.
Hello, Skies fans. Swipe up.
I'm Alex. I handle pre-production logistics.
So Alex is handling all sorts of details behind the scenes,
you know,
getting shit done.
Yep.
This is Matt Deher. Runs the show here.
Yeah.
He tells us what to do.
He's employed by me.
That's correct.
Especially this guy.
Because my visa is under his name, so he is technically my daddy. If you guys are noticing as well, there's significant growth and
what is happening
certain.
Right now? The aliens will be intimidated by my pecs. They show up.
Cut.
Hello.
What is this for?
We're doing a little BTS.
Oh, a little Korean pop.
Just trying to find a coherent way of telling the story because I don't want people to think that we're crazy.
How are you feeling as you rewatch all of this?
I'm just as sold then as I am now. I mean, hearing the way they tell the story, it's like, why would they make it up for 50 years?
What is this junk that I'm listening to?
I thought that those were some good options, Bryce.
Thank you.
Boys and boys.
Toys and boys.
I love them. On a scale of 1 to 10, how far we are in this process, we're at about a 4. I think we'll have a rough assembly tomorrow, which is Wednesday. This video goes up on Sunday. Once we have the rough assembly, we have to get like all the VO done and start layering this. Then we're gonna have to color, sound design, get some graphics done. We got a lot of shit to do.
You know what my grandfather says?
We'll get there.
Will we?
We'll get there.
3.
Your hands are so cold.
1.
Truth tellers.
What are you hoping people get out of this story?
Cut. Because this is gonna be the final thing. You want it to be like a 1-2 for the punchline a little faster.
Yeah.
6 million subscribers for yesterday today.
Woo!
In like an hour.
Nice. 96 people away.
Why do you think it's important to celebrate?
We already don't stop enough to like take in what we're building, because we're just like in it, taking every single opportunity you can to just celebrate the people that you're doing what you're doing with and how big it's become.
T-Boogie, you're speaking to everyone.
Every single person present in the room, I'm so grateful that at any point of our journey, you believed in us, that you're standing there right now, there celebrating all together is just such a special moment. 30, 40 subscribers away from 6 million. And just a few years ago, we were celebrating 20,000, and it felt like the biggest day of our lives. I'm grateful to be able to do this every single day.
Ladies and gentlemen, yes, there is at 6 million subscribers.
I can eat cake whenever I want. My mom can't tell me anything. Mom.
I just watched Unsolved Mysteries maybe for like the 5th, 6th time. Chills every single time. Same. Especially now more, because now I know more things to that story.
Our case will forever be the first case in United States history to be deemed historically true.
I have the second camera of that. That's what I was thinking of.
Oh, second camera of that?
Yeah.
How were you shooting?
Behind him, like through the window.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. Oh, amazing. That would be a great cut.
This is like the gold of the entire video.
I was grabbed again and brought back into this room, and there were these packets put on my body that looked like raisins. Big friggin' raisins. I remember.
How do you make that up? Look at the look of terror.
And there were three hallways that joined it.
Just in the dark where it happened.
Eric, do you want to tell us what happened to you while filming that scene?
No one believes me, so maybe they didn't learn their lesson from this documentary, but as we were entering that space, I literally got hit by something.
Shut up.
They don't learn. You have to believe in people. I thought it was an alien.
Like
this guy. If you believe in my experience, then go buy my merch at stayweird.shop.
Where are you going?
I'm gonna go work out.
No way. Where's HR?
Ow, it hurts. I'm stretching my hand so hard.
And that's a muscle. It's not an oak tree.
What is this?
It feels like an inflatable noodle, maybe.
No.
That's my muscle.
No. What scares me is that we're not at that point. But I know that point's coming.
But it's coming.
Yeah.
Get ready, boys and girls.
It's almost like the anxiety to get to that point is worse than being at that point.
Oh, dear.
What the hell?
This is what we do when we have to get the documentary picture lock tonight. This is how we like to spend our time.
We haven't watched the episode fully through, but we're confident in our abilities. So confident, in fact, that Cam has decided to dress up as an alien fully.
Oh, this is talk about tights.
Hey, you want some tights, boy?
Hey.
What is that? Mark?
Wait, why is it beeping
right now?
What is going on?
What is going on?
What is that? Where's it coming from? Is that a Mark?
Yeah, wait. But he doesn't know what it is.
Yeah, what is going on?
I don't know what the fuck is going on.
What is going on? There have been so many weird tech things today. This is creepy.
He's texting with the founder of the bike company, and the founder said he's never seen this or heard of it.
My ears are ringing.
There's a performance by the alien.
Very high.
I can't.
Bow.
You know what's getting me through this is knowing that you guys are gonna go to stayweird.shop and buy my merch. Stayweird.shop. Stayweird.shop, baby.
He said that he was gonna be the last man standing. It looks like he's the first bitch sleeping.
The first bitch sleeping. I'm not allowed to go to sleep. I don't wanna be the first bitch down.
No, you don't. You know what happens to the first bitch down?
Damn.
take a guess. Alien Man with your fucking alien merch.
Stayweird.shop.
Stayweird.fuckyou.
Fuck. No, that was not a fall asleep. That was meditation. Deep meditation. I was manifesting.
He wasn't good enough for her. He stands up when she let down. He wasn't good enough for her.
No.
We are exactly on the timeline that we intended for this project. It's a huge success for the team right now. I'm so proud of being able to pull it off every time. Every fucking time. We stick to our schedule, it never fails.
This is exactly what they say, it's 5 o'clock somewhere.
Exactly.
I know this video is crazy, but the level of intention and detail going into this is incredible. This story is really amazing, and I'm very impressed by what you guys are doing, so.
Thank you for being here, documenting the BTS and bringing the good vibes. They're very important on days like this.
Video comes out in 12 and a half hours. We're watching the first ever export of the video as one whole. Mar and Matt went to Arizona to film a video.
All right, 3, 2, 1.
I'm here to discuss the so-called flying saucer.
The flying saucer mystery makes headlines.
Flying disc has been found and is now in the possession of the Army.
Our government has lied about UFO information.
Did you do that?
What do you guys think of that?
Play it again.
This gets posted tomorrow, December 6th, 2020. A time it will change history.
A day which will live in infamy.
Truth tellers!
Unite!
We don't have all the truth tellers here, but we have some
of them.
We have four truth tellers.
We're jumping like flies.
Truth tellers!
And you weren't filming the first time, so I'm gonna do it again for comedic effect.
Oh, okay.
I want you to look right into this object, sir.
Why would I do that?
Sorry, I want you to look right into this.
Oh.
Thank you.
Where am I?
Excuse me, miss, I would like you to look right into this object.
Who are you?
Where are we? Go watch the doc.
I'm about back down and Pluto.
This is great.